we'll discuss the De Moivre theorem now. See, cos theta plus I sin theta, if it is whole square is there, what is the value? Right? Now, we can write cos theta plus I sin theta whole power 1 into cos theta plus I sin theta whole power 1. We can write it, right? And we know that cos theta plus I sin theta, we can write as sys theta into. And here again, cos theta plus I sin theta, we can write sys theta. We have properties sys theta 1 into sys theta 2 equal to sys of theta 1 plus theta 2, right? That property apply. That is a sys of theta plus theta. It becomes sys 2 theta, right? And expand this one, sys 2 theta. It becomes cos 2 theta plus I sin 2 theta. This is the value of which one? Cos theta plus I sin theta whole square. Suppose if it is cos theta plus I sin theta whole power 3 is 1. And we can write this one, cos theta plus I sin theta whole power 2 into cos theta plus I sin theta whole power 1. Now, what is the value of this one? Cos 2 theta plus I sin 2 theta into cos theta plus I sin theta. This is what? Sys 2 theta, right? And this one is sys theta. Again, this is in the form of sys theta 1 into sys theta 2. We can write sys of theta 1 plus theta 2. That is a sys of 3 theta. And if I expand, what will get? Cos 3 theta plus I sin 3 theta. This is the cos theta plus I sin theta whole power 3. In general, if it is 4, guess it what will be? Cos 4 theta plus I sin 4 theta. And so on. If you take n, cos n theta plus I sin n theta. Right? That is called the De Moivre theorem. Cos theta plus I sin theta whole power n. It is there. You can write cos n theta plus I sin n theta. This is called the De Moivre theorem. And this theorem we can prove by using the induction on n. And we know that in induction properties at n equal to 1, n equal to k, n equal to k plus 1. First case, take n equal to 1. If you take n equal to 1, what is the LHS? Cos theta plus I sin theta whole power 1. And what will be the RHS? Cos theta plus I sin 1 into theta. Observe both LHS equal RHS same, right? So for n equal to 1, it is true. Now, in second case, assume that for n equal to k, it is true. We have to assume that it is n equal to, for n equal to k, it is true. That is cos theta plus I sin theta whole power k equal to cos k theta plus I sin k theta. Take it as equation number 1. Now, in the third step, let n equal to k plus 1. If you prove for n equal to k plus 1, LHS and RHS are same, then it is true for all natural numbers of n. Right? So, considering n equal to 1, n equal to k plus 1, what will be LHS? Cos theta plus I sin theta whole power k plus 1. And what is the RHS? Cos of k plus 1 into theta plus I sin of k plus 1 into theta. Now we have to prove that both are same. Now we'll simplify the LHS. It is in the form of a power m plus n. We can write as a power m into a power n. So cos theta plus I sin theta whole power k into cos theta plus I sin theta whole power 1. And by the first equation, cos theta plus I sin theta whole power k value is what? Cos theta plus cos k theta plus I sin k theta. This value substitute here. Cos k theta plus I sin k theta into cos theta plus I sin theta. Now it is in the general multiplication, multiply cos k theta into whole term. Cos k theta into cos theta return. Next, cos k theta into I sin theta. That is I cos k theta sin theta. Next, multiply with I sin k theta. Now I sin k theta into I into I square. I square value is minus 1. So minus sin k theta into sin theta. Now in this we have real parts and imaginary parts. So real parts observe cos k theta cos theta minus sin k theta sin theta. If you observe that cos k theta sin k theta cos theta sin theta, clearly this is in the form of cos A cos B minus sin A sin B. We know that it is that cos of A minus B, cos of A minus B. Now from these two terms clearly I is there, so we can take I common. If you take I common, what will you get it? Sin theta cos k theta, sin k theta cos theta. That is in the form of sin A cos B plus cos A sin B. So what we can write it? Cos A cos B minus sin A sin B. Here observe it, one thing. Cos k theta cos theta minus sin k theta sin theta. So it is in the form of cos of A plus B. Cos of A plus B, what is the formula? Cos A cos B minus sin A sin B. That formula we are applying here. Cos A cos B minus sin A sin B. Cos of A plus B plus I common. If you take I common, what is the formula we are getting? Sin A cos B plus cos A sin B. Sin of A plus B. Take theta common. What will get? Cos K plus 1 into theta plus I sin K plus 1 into theta, which is nothing but RHS, right? So it's this one satisfies for n equal to 1, n equal to k, n equal to k plus 1. So this one is true for all n belongs to natural number.